have to form myself as I have never really formed before and try to help you to form some sort of reasoned estimate of the most romantic figure in the recent history of mathematics. Ramanujan was an Indian, and I suppose that it is always a little difficult for an Englishman and an Indian to understand one another properly. I owe more to him than to anyone else in the world, and my association with him is the one romantic incident of my life. He was, in a way, my discovery. I did not invent him. Like other great men, he invented himself. The difficulty for me, then, is not that I do not know enough about him, but that I know and feel too much.
You can also see I've been conducting my own mathematical researches.
You've no degree.
You're unemployable. I'll write you a recommendation, maybe someone.
With all due respect, sir, I have recommendations. What I need is a job. Please, I have a wife.
You people are all the same. Now get out. Now!
I'm doomed, like Galileo. He died in poverty, you know.
At least you hold yourself in good esteem. Whatever is written in your fate will happen. You can't change that.
My fate is to have a wife who lives with my mother while I sleep here with you all because the British think I'm a raving lunatic.
As do the Indians.
Where did you get your degree?
I don't have one.
How many do you have?
None.
Who else have you shown this to?
Everyone. The British, the Indians, they all sent me to someone else.
I can offer you a job, but your evenings will have to be spent in helping me understand this.
A job?
Do we have an agreement?
Yes, most certainly, sir.
Good. Send for your wife so you can be together and put this on. Follow me. Sir Francis, here are today's ledgers and our new clerk.
Naraya, how long have you worked for me?
Since I helped to design the bridge on the Godavari, which now requires me to call you Sir Francis.
This man looks as if he lives on the streets. Get him out of here.
Sir, please, forgive my appearance, but I really am quite exceptional with numbers. What you might see now is ordinary glass. I promise you will soon remain to see a diamond.
Oh. Your accounts had better be half as polished as your ego.
This is it. the best I could do for now.
It's a home.
Please.
Where is the kitchen?
It's inside. From the wedding. Don't worry, I will sleep on the floor. I'm used to it. I have to go back to work now.
Why aren't you using the abacus?
It was faster in my head.
Impressive. If Sir Francis comes here, at least pretend to use this. I see you've been working on your own formulas. Paper is a precious commodity here. You'll find plenty of packing down by the docks.
Thank you, sir.
See you tonight. Ramanujan, we need to seek an audience with someone who really understands all this.
I've been to everyone in Madras.
Madras. Did you know that the name derives from Mandarajya, the realm of the stupid? There's a whole world out there. And there's England.
You don't come home.
It is I who owe the apology for keeping him. I think it's enough for tonight, Ramanujan.
I'm sorry.
I was told you love numbers more than people.
Some. Not you. Perhaps we can start over. I am Ramanujan.
And I am your wife.
Go ahead. You can look. Please.
What does it all do?
It's like a painting, I think. Only imagine it is with colors you cannot see.
What good is that?
Not much for you, I'm afraid. But for me, it is everything. Maybe there is someone else who can see and understand it as well. And for them, it will be important.
Have you met them?
No, not yet.
I want to understand more than just colors I can't see.
What do you see?
Sand?
Yes. Imagine if we could look so closely that we could see each grain, each particle. You see, there are There are patterns in everything. The color in light.
The reflections on water.
In math, these patterns reveal themselves in the most incredible form. It's quite beautiful.
You should sleep in the bed.
Amma, I've made a friend in my boss. He's going to find somebody to understand my work outside Madras, outside India.
That is an honor.
What nonsense are you talking?
Amma, he sees something in me.
He surely sees enough of you. You're never here at home. Karna, we are Brahmins. It is forbidden to cross the seas.
Ramanujan. Ramanujan, listen to me. This work is too important to die with you. It must be published. If you, an Indian, are at the pinnacle with these formulas, then the British, even while they subjugate us, must recognize that our brightest matches theirs.
Anna, please. I can't.
You have been alone in your mind your whole life. Now other people have the chance to understand you, not just your Namagiri. Imagine.
All I do is imagine.
These first two letters, Baker, Hobson, and who's this?
Oh, that's Hardy. He's a real pot stirrer. You know, he single-handedly reformed the entire tripos examination system, turned over hundreds of years of history. He's your man. Trinity, eh? Kings, prime ministers, Isaac Newton, Byron, now perhaps even you.
Trouble on the continent.
There will be. We beat the frogs by a goal at Twickenham.
I meant in the Balkans.
Ah, the Balkans.
You've got one there seems particularly well traveled. Do you think it's another hoax?
I beg to introduce myself as a clerk in the accounts department.
What this time?
Quite impressive, really. Someone's gone to a lot of trouble. A Hindu clerk. And who claims he can give meaning to the negative values of the gamma function.
Littlewood.
Without doubt. You know, Littlewood, this year alone, I've received correspondence from those who profess to prove the prophetic wisdom of the pyramids, the revelations of the elders of Zion, and the cryptograms which Bacon supposedly buried within the plays of the so-called Shakespeare. But a letter from an ill-educated Indian clerk in Madras challenging assertions I made in the track series really takes the biscuit.
Well, I have to say, I've made similar assertions myself.
So you admit it?
But this was 3 years ago.
No. I'm talking about the letter. Bloody brilliant, I thought. I don't know where you got the postmark.
almost had me fooled.
I simply don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, come on. I'm not a complete idiot.
I don't know how to get this into your thick skull, but whatever it is you're talking about, I'm simply not involved. Play.
So, you've missed Hall.
Not hungry.
I tell you, there is a war coming, no doubt about it. Because we are being led like mindless, spineless sheep, and no one bothers to question any of it. It's coming, all right. You can smell it.
You're as paranoid as Hardy.
With all due respect, Bertie, you couldn't hold a candle. Littlewood, could I have a word?
Yes, of course. Integrals, infinite series, God knows what else. Excuse me. I always forget you don't believe in a supreme being.
Right.
This chap turns out to be genuine. You might have to reconsider.
Well, he must be genuine. Who'd have the imagination to invent all that?
Well, I'm rather flattered you thought I did. These two infinite series are the more intriguing.
Yeah, they defeated me completely. I've never seen anything like them.
Well, it's deceptive. I'll wager the hypergeometric series.
A great Littlewood stumped. He's Hobbes class, I'd say. Being inexperienced, I would very highly value any advice you give me. Yours truly, S. Ramanujan.
What does the S stand for?
You can ask him yourself.
You intend to invite him here?
Oh, no. Much better let him rot away in his office in Madras.
Ah, Mr. Ramanujan. There seems to be a letter for you, postmarked England, Cambridge, England, from a Mr. G.H. Hardy.
I used to come here and watch the boats leaving. I always wondered what it would be like to be on one of them.
I'm finally here, and you talk of crossing the sea. It is forbidden for us. I don't understand. If you go, it will never be the same. This is not Calcutta or Bombay. No one will marry our children. No one will even talk to us.
Then we will move to Calcutta or Bombay. Besides, I don't want to talk to anyone but you.
Do you promise to bring me as soon as you are able? Then that is what we will do. Are you sure you want me to do it?
Cut it.
Om Namo Narayanaha.
Satrisham megha varnam shubhangam lakshmikantam kamalanayanam vande vishvam bhavairam sarvalokaikanatham. Sarvalokaikanatham shashanka chakram sapirita kundalam sapitasam savishiravi eksha.
You cut your hair. What have you done?
Amma.
I've decided to go to England.
Did you? Or did she convince you so that both of you could run away together, huh? This is all her doing. She wants you all to herself. You saw me.
Look after each other while I'm gone.
Never forget your prayers. Cannot pollute yourself with their food if you ever want to come back. Forget me.
I could never. I promise.
Well, off we go. 6,000 miles, can you imagine?
I've known larger numbers.
Don't let it ruin your big day with Gunga Din. I'm sure it won't mean more.
It was Din.
Are you Ramanujan by chance?
Very much by chance.
Ah. Oh, John Littlewood, such a pleasure. I was just on my way to meet you. Well, shall we go together? Yes. The intended effect. Don't be intimidated. Great knowledge often comes from the humblest of origins. Come along. See that sapling? That's the very tree under which Newton sat. The apple dropped on his head and he invented gravity. This way, we've been anticipating your arrival for some time.
Well, I think it's criminal. I mean, we bring these Indians over at great expense, and look what happens.
Yeah, well, it's not just that this chap is Ramanujan, whatever his name is. Indian? After all, we do have Indian students here.
Just not ones with no education to speak of. It's a disgrace.
Ramanujan is a special case.
Why's that, exactly? We've all read his letter. There are no proofs. Are we just supposed to take him at his word?
No. You're to take him at mine. Change, gentlemen. It's a wonderful thing. Embrace it.
Take it as a sign of respect to quieten this lot.
Is Mr. Hardy here? I'm most excited to meet him. He must be a very kind man to bring me all this way.
Ah, speak of the devil.
Hello.
I'm Hardy. Welcome to Trinity, Mr. Ramanujan. Am I pronouncing that properly?
Yes, sir. Perfectly. It's an honor, sir.
Thank you. I
very much look forward to beginning our work. So, tomorrow, 10 o'clock, my rooms. I look forward to it.
Did I say something wrong?
Don't worry. I'll look out for you.
That's if you believe he actually exists. You see, there's speculation that Mr. Littlewood here is merely a figment of Hardy's imagination. If he ever makes a mistake, he'll have someone else to blame.
Ramanujan, Bertrand Russell.
Welcome to our little asylum.
Hello.
Come along, come along.
Get off the grass! It's for fellows only.
Excuse me, sir. Could you direct me to New Court, to Mr. Hardy?
Through there. You have something on your forehead.
Thank you. The shoes, they hurt my feet.
Sorry.
You see, you do exist.
Yes.
Right. Ramanujan, we decided that for the good of everybody, you should attend some lectures.
But I'm here to publish.
Yes, all in good time, I hope. But first we need proofs of your work.
It's really nothing to worry about. It's simply a question, acquainting you with the more formal methods that will benefit our future work together.
I mean, we need a common language. You wouldn't expect us to converse with you in Tamil.
No, but you expect me to speak English.
Quite. So, there'll be plenty of time for publishing.
I'm sorry, but with all humility, how does anyone know that? I don't want this to die with me.
I assure you it won't.
Thank you, sir. But I have much more to share with you. As I told you, the letter only contained a small sampling of my discoveries. You'll see, I have even found a function which exactly represents the number of prime numbers less than x in the form of an infinite series.
Exactly?
Yes, I thought if we were going to publish, it should be something groundbreaking.
Well, this is most unexpected.
Hardy, this will take a lifetime.
Maybe two.
Quite alarming to see you so thoroughly pleased with yourself. Can't have anything to do with these notebooks, can it? You could spend the rest of your life trying to prove half of it. never have another original idea of your own.
Bertie, if I could prove by logic that you were going to die in 5 minutes, I'd be sorry, but my sorrow would be very much mitigated by the pleasure in the proof.
You might get your wish granted. Half the continent up in flames and old men like that running the show.
Yeah. No, you're just a bit sore because you're worried he'll be up there before you are.
Oh, I doubt a dark face will ever grace these walls, let alone become a fellow.
Ramanujan, over here. Come over, sit with us. Welcome to all. I'm Chandra Mahalanobis.
Hello.
And this is Andrew Hartley.
I am Ramanujan.
Well, everyone knows who you are, mate. Words out, you've taken on the prime number theorem.
It is quite extraordinary them bringing you here like this. Such an honor.
There are other Indians?
A few. You're from the south. Calcutta myself. This must be quite a shock for you.
The truth is, you've more in common than you think. His father was a school teacher. Not exactly Trinity stock. Hardy's earned it on his own merit. That's probably why he's taken to you.
Does he have a wife?
No.
He's married to his work, as they say. I suppose that means you now.
Stop. He's a vegetarian.
Very sorry.
Potato, sir. How's that any better? Your potatoes are cooked in lard.
I'm so sorry.
Not at all. But I think I will go. I hope to see you soon.
Ramanujan! Did you have a good dinner? They make a fine mutton.
Yes, sir. Delicious.
And your rooms? Satisfactory? I want everything to be to your advantage so that we can be as productive as possible.
Thank you, sir. Very nice paper.
Well, use it wisely. Well, I'll say good night then.
All right. Now, you. Are you following this?
Yes, sir. Most excitedly.
Well, you don't appear to be taking any notes. Is there something you'd like to contribute? Well, go on then. Come on. You'll need the chalk.
But I hadn't completed that proof. How do you know? I don't know. I just do.
Well, gentlemen, that appears that our time is up. Thank you for your attention. Not you. Little Wog, let me tell you something. You don't pull a stunt like that in my class. You don't belong here, and you can tell your master Hardy I said as much. Now get out!
my sacred thread. It's to help ward off evil spirits.
How did it work with Mr. Howard?
I'm sorry, sir. I got too excited.
Not a word often associated with his lectures. How did you know that theorem?
It came to me. Mr. Hardy, I don't understand why we waste our time doing all these proofs. I have the formulas.
It's not that I can't see what you claimed. It's that I'm not sure that you know how you got there. Or indeed that your claims are correct. There are subtleties which...
But they are right, sir. I have more important new ideas.
Yes, but intuition is not enough. It has to be held accountable. And a little humility would go a long way. Why do you think they want us to fail?
Because I'm Indian.
Well, yep, there is that. But also, because of what we represent. Now, Euler and Jacobi, who were they?
Mathematicians.
Just names to you. Euler was the most productive mathematician of the 18th century. Most of his work done after he was blind. Jacobi, like you, was snatched from obscurity and was almost as impressive as Euler. Now, I think you are in their class. What they had in common, what I see in you, is a love of form. It's all through your notebooks. Let me ask you something. Why do you do it, any of this?
Because I have to. I see it.
Like Euler. Form for its own sake. An art unto itself. And like all art, it reflects truth. It's the only truth I know. It's my church. And you, just as Mozart could hear an entire symphony in his head, you dance with numbers to infinity. But this dance, this art, does little to endear us to certain factions who see us as mere conjurers. So if we are going to challenge areas of mathematics that are so well trod, we cannot afford to be wrong. I need you to attend your lectures, don't offend your professors, and keep doing your proofs. Otherwise, this experiment of ours will be doomed to failure. Come with me. I want to show you something. There are many ways to be honored in life. For us, being elected a fellow is certainly one, but in my humble opinion, to leave a legacy here at the Wren after we are gone is the greatest. This library houses the epistles of St. Paul, the poems of Milton, Morgan's Bible. But in my estimation, as a man of numbers, the pièce de résistance is Newton's Principia Mathematica. Now, just as Newton represents the physical aspect of our work, your notebooks represent the abstract. It took a long time for Newton to be proved. Which is why we have an obligation to prove these. And if we do, I believe that one day, these notebooks will find their place here. Now, do you understand what's at stake here? Good.
I hope you are taking care of yourself and that Mr. Hardy is good to you. Everyone here is so proud of you, but most proud of all is me. I spend every day missing you and waiting for your letter to tell me I'm coming to be with you across the ocean. You are my everything.
I've discovered a new series.
Look, I'm not interested in a new series. I thought I'd explain this. I need your proofs. We had an agreement.
Just please look at it, sir. It is true.
How do you know that?
Because it is written.
Written where, Ramanujan? Now, take my coat, go home and get properly dressed before you freeze.
Sir, I've come a very long way to be here. And you promised to help me publish.
Don't look at me like that. It's for his own good.
You wouldn't think he's so bloody smart by the way he dresses. What the devil is that anyway?
Partitions. No, 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 wait. This even you could understand. P of 4 equals 5. Now all that means is there are 5 ways to add up the number 4. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. 3 plus 1, 2 plus 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2, and 4.
Seems simple enough.
Yeah. So it does. But when you raise the number of P to 100, there are 204,226 different combinations. Major McMahon did it by hand. It took him weeks. Now he thinks he can figure out a formula. Plug in the number, any number, and out comes the number of partitions like magic.
I take it you have tried to crack this one before.
It's considered impossible, unsolvable. Bloody rabbit hole mystery of the universe.
Until now? Din, din, din. Gunga din.
Using the divergence theorem, what is the flux of F through S here?
What on earth's he doing?
Proofs.
Proofs?
Yeah.
You should let him run, Hardy. You shouldn't stifle him.
He's gone to the cricket. Just follow the umbrella.
I've been over those proofs of yours, if you can call them that, very carefully. And I've marked where you're missing steps and where you've made mistakes. There's much more I could say, but that's where you should begin. Listen, I'm hard on you for your own benefit, so that you can be published.
But, sir, you can publish the notebooks and my prime number theorem. You've had them since I arrived.
There's nothing I'd like more, but if I was to publish them in their present state, I'd be sent to the lunatic asylum.
You don't understand these. I don't think about this the same way you do. These steps you want, what you want, I do not know how to do.
Well, you can just begin by trying your best and see if you don't surprise yourself.
Sir, do you know something I don't?
Apparently not. Oh, no. God and I don't see exactly eye to eye. So if I prepare for rain, then it won't. So far, so good. I am Hardy, and I'm spending the afternoon in the Wren Library. Now we're sure to have sunshine. You see, I'm what you call an atheist.
No, sir. You believe in God, you just don't think he likes you.
Oh, really? Listen, I wasn't gonna give you this just yet, but I took the liberty of doing some of your proofs myself, just to show you what together we can achieve. See? You've been published.
Mr. Hardy, thank you! Thank you, sir!
It is with great pride that today all of us have shared the publication of my son's article in the London Mathematical Society. Such a big thing, a very prestigious society, huh? Mommy, Paragon, and I'm in Ramanujan, huh?
So how really is the little genius?
Don't pay attention to her. She's not proud enough of his achievements, huh? Paranga, mommy.
Ramanujan! Wake up. It just came over the wire. We're at war.
Here?
No, silly Belgium. Now, come on, the king's arriving.
Bloody jingoes. Bertie's asked me to help him with his union of democratic controls. And
agitating already.
Well,
you know, I received a letter from the War Office this morning. Seems they need some assistance with ballistics.
Ballistics? You?
Yeah, I know. I did try to explain, but they're rather a dense lot.
Yeah.
Anyway, you probably won't miss me. There's an ongoing theory that I'm merely a figment of your imagination.
That's not true.
Ah, Ramanujan's out there. There's a reason he doesn't like proofs, you know. He may be disagreeable to his formulas.
How do you mean?
Well, I've been having some reservations about some of his work.
Oh.
Well, what did you expect? He may belong to a world beyond us, but he's not God.
Well, that's a relief.
He's not.
How will Janki overcome now?
Don't worry. They say it'll be over by Christmas.
Please finish by telling him that, of course, I will come. And not to worry about the war. It is far away from here. And that I will wait for him to make the necessary arrangements. Also, that I love him very much. That is all.
Make your mark here. I knew your husband, but he spent all the time at the temple. He's still there, in the alcove.
Amma, please, will you post this for him? He needs to know I will still come with the war. Emma, please let me help you.
Where are all the vegetables?
Rationing for the war.
Thank you.
There is no letter for you.
Please, can you check again?
I already looked again. Now you're holding up the queue.
His mum forgot to write him.
Look who it is. The genius Wog. Can you believe they send us off while he kips here in luxury? Oi! Where do you think you're going? You freeloading little blackie. Hey! Hey! I'm talking to you. Hey! This is our home. Don't you forget it.
Victory at any price. Victory for whom?
Exactly.
I understand that it's inevitable that anybody primarily interested in peace should be unpopular in a time of war. But perhaps that is all the more reason that we should exist. Mr. Littlewood has very kindly offered us his rooms while he is away solving the intricacies of ballistics for which he is so ill-suited.
So please keep your hands off my books.
By that he means his whiskey collection.
Thank you all very much for coming. Bless you. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming. Cheek.
This was so fast, and ours were in completely the wrong position.
What is the meaning of this?
I'd have thought you'd choose your battles more wisely. After all, it's only the goodwill of the college that allows Ramanujan here.
What the bloody hell does the UDC have to do with Ramanujan?
You should know that your friend Russell is going to lose his lectureship as a result of the leaflets he's been distributing. We have heard that others are doing the same.
Are you threatening me?
Mr. Howard is simply trying to enlighten you as to the precariousness of your situation. You are perfectly at liberty to take the matter to the College Council.
And rest assured, I shall, on principle.
Well, that's a rather dangerous word with all your liberal colleagues in France. Change, Hardy, that's what you wanted. Now you get used to it.
From Mr. Littlewood, sir. If I may, he's so misplaced on a battlefield, I shouldn't think a bullet would recognize him as a target.
My dear Harold, please forgive this personal transgression. I'm gone now to this god-awful war, and haven't the faintest idea if I will ever return. Fortunately, unlike you, I do have God to take comfort in. I have 2 points to make. The first is that Ramanujan's work on primes, while brilliant in itself, is actually wrong. The other point is less straightforward. You have in Ramanujan nothing short of a miracle. The man exceeds any notion of brilliance that I have ever understood. Forget Jacobi. We can compare him with Newton. I have come to believe that for Ramanujan, every single positive integer is one of his personal friends. And to that end, you too have a responsibility. You have to look after him and make sure that his work amounts to something. Don't let Howard and his lot win. So you see, Hardy, you too have a war to fight. Just don't let it be with Ramanujan.
So, there you have it. He left this for you to see for yourself. Your theorem on primes is wrong.
It's not. It can't be.
It's rather interesting, really. If you compare the prime number approximation with the actual number of primes, calculation tells us what?
It always proves higher.
Even at 1,000? 1,000,000? 1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,
give it to you. It proves it.
No, because however intuitively obvious it may seem, when subject to calculation, it fails. Mr. Littlewood has calculated a number, and it shows that your theorem will sometimes predict less, not more, than the actual number of primes. Your theorem is wrong. And this is why we cannot publish any more until you finally trust me on this business of proofs. Intuition can only carry you so far.
Stop! I can't hear this anymore. Intuition? You say this word as if it is nothing. Is that all it is to you? All that I am?
Look, I'm sorry. Am I missing something?
You've never even seen me, let alone know me. You are a man of no faith. I don't see pictures of anyone here, not even family. Who are you, Mr. Hardy?
How dare you? How dare you judge me?
But it is you who does of me, don't you see?
No. Quite frankly, I don't.
Don't you know what I've given up to be here? I have nothing. Do you even see the bruises on my face? I have a wife, Mr. Hardy.
last.
Ramanujan, is that you?
Mr. Hardy.
You're not well?
Nothing serious.
Sure?
I'm just off to the Wren. Believe it or not, if you can find your way around the beds, there are still some books there. Those proofs you left, wonderful. Really wonderful. So, we start work again? Tomorrow morning?
Yes, sir.
Good. I'm very sorry, sir. He was a fine young man, best of his year.
They were all fine young men. All the knowledge they gained here. Sacrificed for a few yards of land. They say it's the price of victory.
Hmm? Well, Bertie. I'm worried about Ramanujan.
Why?
Well, he doesn't seem quite himself.
What would you know about that?
Very little, I admit. But I don't think he's well. He seems to have changed. We had a terrible row the other night about intuition of all things, and he stormed out, and then a day later he produces these wonderful proofs.
Well, Harold, you've got your way.
How do you mean?
You and your damned rigor has finally broken his spirit. I warned you to let him run.
Yes, but he's not a bloody racehorse.
No, he's not. But as you've hardly treated him as a human being, I suppose... Well, I suppose a horse isn't a bad place to start.
Major, can I have a word?
I don't have time for you.
Partitions. It's Ramanujan.
The gall. The unbridled arrogance.
He won't be able to do it without you.
He won't be able to do it at all.
I've been going over your work on partitions. Seems to me you're on the verge of a major breakthrough. So now you've begun to embrace some proper rigor. I think you should meet Major McMahon. He's the leader in combinatorics at the university and also happens to be one of your most vocal opponents. He says partitions can't be done. Especially by the likes of you.
Then you better start counting very high.
Enter at your own risk.
Ah! I've been waiting for you. Square root of 58,639. Now!
242.
242 what?
0.1549090.
Yes, child's play. Try me.
Go on.
Same number squared.
3,438,532,321. Ha! Thrashed you! Combinatorics, that's what I do. Glorified dice throwing. Bloody nerve of you both. You fail on primes, then you think you can just turn round and crack partitions. Can't be done, I'm telling you. Especially not by you.
It can. And I will.
No, I will. By hand. By slow and painful addition. And then you can be absolutely certain that whatever formula you two can dream up will be quite wrong. Then you can crawl back under whatever rock you came from in India, and we can put to bed this charade of yours, Hardy. Now, how high do I have to go?
Be of 200 to do. I really can do it.
Here we are, P of 200, the moment of truth. You know, I was stationed in Madras once. Yeah. Well, you first. What has your formula given you?
3,972,998 million.
My God. You're close. Within 2%. Well, I'll be damned.
Major McMahon, may I introduce you to Mr. Ramanujan?
How long?
3 weeks.
Mm-hmm. And the fever?
Hunger.
Breathe in.
Breathe in.
Oh, it's not good. You've all the early signs of tubercular. I'm sorry. You're a breeding ground for infection.
I'm so sorry, Ramanujan. But he can never know. It's a Zeppelin! Over here! I'm being punished. It's just a fever.
Has he wrote yet?
No. Where are you going?
see? You were right. Cauchy's theorem will work. It's just leading to this circle concept.
At 2,000, it should bring it down to less than 1% or so. And as n goes to infinity, the error goes to zero. You see? You're beginning to see the nuances and complexities which you were only catching at a glance before. What an unlikely team we make. If we really crack partitions, this will be a monumental breakthrough. Did I tell you I put you up for a fellowship?
Mr. Hardy. Thank you.
You getting enough to eat? I mean, I know there are shortages, but there's still plenty of good grub in Hall.
I'm all right. It's nothing.
Let me ask you something. How does all this come to you?
I don't know.
Why am I bothering with a council meeting when I'm getting the boot?
If you think I'm going to have that charlatan for a fellow, you're very much mistaken.
Oh, please tell me you didn't propose him.
He's going to crack partitions.
Oh.
He's worthy. You're the one who told me to let him run like a damned horse. Well, I did. Now I need to raise his spirits.
You mean you need to relieve your own guilt?
Really, for someone so clever, you can be so terribly dim.
So, in the matter of fellowship for Srinivasa Ramanujan, we call the matter to vote.
I'm sorry to bother you so late. I felt I should be the one to tell you. I'm very embarrassed for myself and for the college, but your fellowship was denied.
Thank you for telling me. I know you did all you could.
Ramanujan.
Nurse!
Shall I wake him?
No. He'll come when he's ready.
Excuse me, Doctor. This gentleman's looking for the Indian student.
Ah, yes. He came in last night. Not right in the head. Terrible fever. He was here.
Your condition has worsened. You may not have long. You should set your affairs in order. Do you have any family here? Anyone?
Something's happened in London.
Call me a taxi, would you?
He was very lucky with the train. The conductor saw him before he jumped. The danger is his lungs.
Yes, he's had a bad cough for some time.
It is no cough. He has advanced tuberculosis.
Is there nothing we can do?
Pray. It will take a miracle.
Mr. Hardy. I'm sorry for the trouble I've caused you.
Give me quite a scare. Self-prophesying.
My wife has forgotten me. I have no one.
I understand that you might feel like that, but you should have told me. I could have helped. No, it just as easily could have been me.
Well, I'm glad it wasn't. You have cause enough with Ramanujan. I'll be thinking of you both.
Where will you go?
Oh, I'll go down the road to Oxford. And I'll wait for them to beg to have me back here. Goodbye, Harold.
Bye, Bertie.
Too bad he couldn't take Hardy with him. I still don't see what he bloody contributes.
Yeah, I had words with Major McMahon.
It seems that Ramanujan's on the verge of a major breakthrough. That's right. Partitions.
Oh, that's impossible.
Remains to be seen.
God, it's freezing in here. Are you warm enough?
Try sleeping. I have to go to that pipe just so I don't freeze. It would have been better for all had the train done its job.
Oh, yeah. You could have been reincarnated as a pigeon turd. Sorry, I've not been able to be a better friend to you in the traditional sense. I know you've needed one, but I'm not very good at all of that. I never have been. Life for me is... it's always been mathematics.
You wanted to know how I get my ideas? My God. Hamagiri. She speaks to me. Puts formulas on my tongue when I sleep. Sometimes when I pray. Do you believe me? Because if you are my friend, then you will know that I'm telling you the truth. If you are truly my friend.
But I don't believe in God. I don't believe in anything I can't prove.
Then you can't believe in me. Don't you see? An equation has no meaning to me unless it expresses a thought of God. Maybe it is better that we just remain what we were.
When I was at school, I remember one of my chaplains saying, you know God exists because he's like a kite and you can feel the tug on the string. He's up there. I said, what if there's no wind and the kite can't fly? No, I can't believe in God. I don't believe in the immemorial wisdom of the East, but I do believe in you.
Thank you. I very much want to finish what we started.
Good. I brought some calculations in case you were feeling a bit better.
And then I want to go home.
Home?
As soon as I'm able. What if I should die? You have to promise that you will get me home.
You're not going to die. Oh, this came for you. I'll leave you in peace. Try and do what the doctors ask. I know it's not in your nature.
I will never know why you have chosen to forsake me. Just a letter in response to the multitude I have sent you would have been enough. I have gone to be with my brother and his family where I will remain. This last letter is to say goodbye.
What happened?
I don't know. He's a terrible patient. Doesn't believe in medicine, won't eat anything, just prays to his Namagiri.
Well, I'd be praying too if you were my doctor. I'm a bloody atheist. Is this my fault?
Yes. Maybe. Within 0.004. This can't die with me, Mr. Hardy.
You're not going to die. If this is correct, you'll make a difference.
have the proofs.
My God. He did it. He really did it.
Now he must be a fellow.
Oh, be practical, Hardy. He'll only fail again.
Not with your help, he won't. Besides, there is another way. If he was a... if he had a royal fellowship.
An FRS? He's Indian.
McMahon, listen to me. He really needs this. See that this gets to Lieutenant Littlewood.
Littlewood? Where?
Mr. Hobson, Mr. Baker, I have someone who wishes to talk to you about Mr. Ramanujan.
Gentlemen. Trinity denied him. I just want the opportunity to make the case. Try him on his merits.
Suit yourself, but I think you'll find the result will be the same.
Now what have you got yourself involved with?
Sean.
Good of you to come.
Wouldn't have missed it for the world.
So, now we see the work on partitions and the enormous breakthrough that has been achieved. All this, mind you, by a man whose limitations of knowledge when I met him were as startling as was its profundity. Opinions may differ as to the importance of Ramanujan's work and the influence it may or may not have on the mathematics of the future, but one gift it does show is its profound and invincible originality. Mr. Littlewood once told me that every positive integer is one of Ramanujan's personal friends. I believe this to be true. He told me that an equation for him had no meaning unless it expressed a thought of God. Well, despite everything in my being set to the contrary, perhaps he is right. For is this not exactly our justification for pure mathematics? We are merely explorers of infinity in the pursuit of absolute perfection. We do not invent these formulae, they already exist and lie in wait for only the very brightest of minds, like Ramanujan, ever to divine and prove. So, in the end, I have been forced to consider, who are we to question Ramanujan? Let alone God. Thank you.
Bad enough that this charlatan has wasted our time once, and now Hardy's dragged the only person in the world who'll support him out of the trenches. No, enough is enough with this Ramanujan.
Littlewood is not the only one. I think he has the finest mind I've seen in my lifetime, and his name is Ramanujan.
Hardy.
fellow of the Royal Society.
He wrote me. If you had gone to him, he would never return.
Are you really going to go home?
War is over. This time.
As a fellow of the Royal Society, they're going to be really proud of you.
I owe you so much.
No. It's I who owe you. Come on, the grass. You're late.
But, sir, I can't. I'm not a fellow here.
Are you sure about that? As an FRS, what could they say?
Repeat after me. I, Srinivas Ramanujan, elected fellow of Trinity College.
I, Srinivas Ramanujan, elected fellow of Trinity College.
Sorry I'm late. Bloody cab driver got lost. Should have known from his number.
And what was that?
Rather a dull one. 1729.
No, Hardy. It is a very interesting number. It is the smallest number expressible as the sum of two cubes in two different ways.
Have you notified your family? Just not her.
I don't even know if she got my letter.
I'm rather out of my depth in such affairs, but I will say this. There are no proofs nor underlying laws that can determine the outcome of matters of the heart. Of this, I'm sure.
Perhaps when we meet again, you will have such matters of your own. I will miss you, my friend.
I will miss you. So, I want to let up with you with all your new work every week and come back to us in a year's time.
I promise.
Afternoon post, sir.
Thank you.
India.
At last.
he coming back, sir?
It is difficult to put into words what I owe Ramanujan. His originality has been a constant source of suggestion to me ever since I first met him. And his death, is one of the worst blows I have ever felt. But now I say to myself when I'm depressed and I find myself forced to listen to tiresome and pompous people, well, I've done something you could never have done. I have collaborated with both Littlewood and Ramanujan on something like equal terms.
Let's take this one.
What? 1729. I don't see what's so special about this one.
Neither did I at first.